Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough, if you can even call this a walkthrough at the point. Let's go to the next battle zone, battle mode arena thingy here. This place is pretty cool, I have to say. I love the way the blocks disintegrate as you blast them with bombs. Needless to say, you gotta pay attention as to where the computers are, or, you know, wherever your buddies are if you're playing this with multiple players. You can play this with up to four players if you have an accessory called a multi-tap. But so few people own that thing, so the most players that you'll ever get into a game will usually be just two, and then you'll trade off controllers or something like that. Unless you're playing, like, on a emulator and then using the netplay option or something like that, like in ZSNES here, there's a netplay thingy. I have no idea how it works, and I just killed myself there. I panicked. So I'll just see how the computers mess with each other here. Those tunnels, you can tell the computers know where everything is for sure, but if you aren't paying attention, you're gonna get blasted. It's sort of like the, you know how when they get the skull power-up, if you can even call that a power-up, what'll happen is that the, if you go invisible, they'll be able to tell where they are, and you won't be able to tell where you are. Yeah, it's that sort of problem. So I guess the AI is good like this, but I didn't pay attention at all, did I? Oh, that was just terrible. Terrible playing on my part there. Oh, but alas, the game will go on, because the Black Bomber just died right there. Because, you know, it takes two games to win per match, and if the Black Bomber's already gone, well, you can't win the match, so the games go on! By the way, this music is really, really catchy, in case you can't tell. At this moment in time, because I'm not playing, this is like post-commentary sports announcing or something like that, so I get... What the heck just happened right there? Red Bomber just, like, didn't duck around the corner enough and it got blasted. So, yeah, it's like I'm commentating over some sort of sports event when I'm not playing. It's kind of odd, actually. Maybe I should get into that a little more. I don't know, maybe it's... Maybe it's something that I should practice for situations like this. I'm just speculating here. No, not the invisibility. Please, not the invisibility. I don't know where they are. Well, at least where the blue one is, so I'm just going to carefully wander around and away from them. So, oh, wait, it's over there. No, please don't. Please don't touch me. I don't like bodily contact. I would very much appreciate... I'm germophobic, and I just can't have that sort of thing, so please respect my wishes and not... touch me and give me... Oh, jeez. It just keeps getting passed from Bomberman to Bomberman. I'm getting so frightened. Oh, jeez. They're right there. Okay, it wore off. I'm good. PkGam is good. All right. It looks like everyone is still alive somehow. That's pretty odd, actually. Oh, jeez. No. Don't you dare try and trap me. But you're trying to trap me. Oh, no. I can't be there. Oh, that was just tragic. That was terrible. I'm not winning any match this game, and it appears that the Blue Bomber is the winner of this match, and I failed hard. Oh well, you can't win them all. Don't know why I did so badly that time, but whatever. Victory can't come to me every time. Next battle mode is... No, I don't want that. Wait, is the computer still at 10? Yeah, it is. Okay. The Duel Zone! If you can't tell, first one to the outside is probably going to be the winner. So I'm just going to zoom. Yeah, baby! For the win! I don't know why I added a 4 to the win there, but there you go. How did Black Bomber get caught in my explosion when it knows exactly what my firepower is? I will never know. Alright, so it's me versus the other one that got more powers. I believe it was the red one. I wasn't really paying much attention to whoever was going around the other side. Yeah, it was the red one. Okay, that's fine with me. Unless the blue one is going to outwit both of us at maximum firepower, but I would highly doubt that. So yeah, that's the gimmick of this stage, is the fact that everyone gets, I mean, the one that gets the outside the fastest in that very tight starting area is probably going to be the winner, for the sheer fact that, you know, you have more of an advantage than anyone else. But you won't always win if you get, you know, all those power-ups along the edges, but the chances are high that it's gonna happen. Alright, next one, I'm going to be just as aggressive as before, hopefully. shouldn't they be dropping bombs to stay aggressive too? I don't know. Go, 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 go! Go, 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 get that other... Oh, shoot, dang you, Xbox controller, you screwed me again. I got caught up with the pressure. Nah, it's not the controller, it's me. As I said, I'm still not used to playing with this thing, because I don't play PC games enough, nor use my Xbox controller enough to get used to the D-pad, but otherwise it works fine, as you see me zooming around the area like that without any trouble most of the time, but when the pressure's on my thumb, it just doesn't work for me. Alright, so far it's a stalemate. Should I be attempting to do something tricky? Like maybe that. That may work. Dang you, I got a dud! That's a very rare occurrence that you see right there. If you don't have bombs, if you don't have more than one bomb, that leaves you waiting for that bomb to relight itself, relight its fuse. You know what, I'm gonna try and get you trapped in a corner so that you get squished, if at all possible, or that works for me too. Woo! And another victory goes to me! Why am I so excited? I don't know. Alright, that's good enough. We've seen that screen enough times, and we're gonna go over to the flower zone! Nom 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 nom, snarly teeth. Okay, I'll stop now. You'll notice that the gardeners that are appearing there, they're not really doing anything other than moving the bombs away from the screen, which is the gimmick of this stage. So they don't hurt you at all, even though they ride over you, which makes absolutely no sense. as you can see, that was terrible on my part. I didn't duck around the corner fast enough. As you can see, there is the remote control here. So pretty much anyone who gets the remote control first is going to be the winner. Well, I'm sure there's enough power-ups to go around, but by the time other players get the remote control, you've pretty much got a ridiculous advantage. Oh, and I see when they touch a bomb, it actually stops it from moving. That's interesting. I mean, it stops it from exploding. I didn't know that. I wasn't really paying attention to that the last time. Oh, geez. Even though I have the remote control, I can't really take advantage of it too much here because of the fact that I've only got one bomb, and, you know, I can't trap enemies like that with just one bomb all the time. Alas. No, no, no. Aww. That is sad. Okay, now I got another bomb. Oh, that works. and also those flowers, as you see, they grow back every once in a while. I wonder if I should start attempting to move the enemy into the corner. Like, to try and get it to get squished, or I can just glitch the AI, that works for me as well. And I'm gonna reap the spoils while the screen goes black for no reason whatsoever, and start another battle. Those flowers are so... I swear, they look so much like piranha plants. But they're so kawaii. Yes, I just said kawaii. I'm just being ultra weird here. Just for the sake of being ultra weird, and I accidentally hit the button of all things. Wow. I can't even take advantage of my remote control. Oh, also, I should mention, when the rest of the players die, Bombs will no longer explode on top of your invincibility, so any bombs that are about to explode will be stuck in purgatory, like that one that just had a dud right there. I'm just gonna blast it just to speed up the process a little bit and let me drop two bombs again. I hate those dud bombs at times. No, not that! Why? Just why do I keep getting that? I should say, why do I keep getting contaminated with it? That's the word I'm thinking of. Oh, wait, do I have... Oh, I did... I mean, I don't have the remote control bombs, alas. So there is nothing that I could do right there. And I mean, I couldn't grab the remote control, otherwise, you know, I would have got caught up in that blast. And, oh well. Yeah, alright, one down, two to go. How it goes, I don't know. Oh, jeez. Oh, I should have pressed the X button to stop it. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, jeez. Oh, this is getting tight. Sort of. Oh, jeez. Ah, I panicked. Alright, how's this gonna go between blue and black? Black and blue. Black is gonna be dumb. And blue is the winner of this match. With two trophies. Well, that's how many you need to win, of course. Next one! Let's go. I think it's gonna be the last one I'm gonna be doing in this part. And I don't remember what it was. The light zone. Oh, I have no idea how this is gonna look in the emulation. Because those... I should say in the recording, because those spotlights there, they flash at a different frames per second than this recording. I'm pretty sure it flashes at 30 frames per second, because that's just how things when they flash in games typically are. And that just might mess up the recording, I'm unsure, but it might not mess it up too much. We'll see how things go, I suppose. I have to show the stage one way or the other, so... Yeah, I found out that they flash at... I mean, when games have something that flash like that, that they usually flash at 30 frames per second. I recognize that because... Oh, shoot. In my Sonic 3 walkthrough, when I did the remake sort of with Knuckles, when you were at the Emerald Select screen, like when you were going to the... Oh, shoot. When you were at the... Like for the special stages, when you would jump on one of the super emeralds, they would look like that they were a solid color, meaning that they were flashing at the same rate my camera was. And I think my camera recorded at 30 frames per second. The other camera I recorded at the time, dang auto drop bomb thing and super speed. Oh wait, maybe it was. Maybe they flash at 60 frames per second. Well, either way, it doesn't match up with the. With the PAL recording speed here, that you know that I'm using for the recording, as I explained before, so that might mess it up a little bit, but that's all right. You can still see what's going on, even if the spotlights don't show, or if they show all the time. I don't know how it's gonna turn out, but when you play this yourself, you'll be able to see that the spotlights that are on the screen are actually flashing. But otherwise, the stage's gimmick is just the fact that it's dark, and it's hard to see. But it's not really all that much of a gimmick, actually, so it's a pretty basic stage overall. And that's it, the Black Bomber is the winner this time. And I'm gonna end it off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part.